Hey everybody, what's going on? Revolution Hell Cowboy here. And this video is one I've been planning to do for a while now, and with the holiday season coming up and all the things that have been going on in the news with this place that I'm about to talk about, and I've talked about it a few times in some of my previous videos, and place I enjoyed very much as a kid and even as an adult I still liked, but in recent years I just don't care for the place anymore, especially since some of the things I'm going to mention in this video are reasons why I've stopped shopping there and take my business elsewhere. And just, I don't know, the place is going downhill and I don't know how much longer it'll be around, you know. And the place I'm talking about is Toys R Us. I mean, like I said, it was a place I loved as a kid and, you know, I was hoping maybe it could still be a great place today, but honestly it was, as times change, trends change, kids don't want to play with toys as much anymore, they want to play video games. It's like, kids now are outgrowing toys faster than when I was a kid. Heck, I still haven't outgrown toys. I mean, come on, I have them behind me. I don't play with them, honestly, I collect them. I mean, I'll admit, if I buy a loose figure, I might play with it for fun and then put it on my shelf, but also, you know, times change, more people like me are collecting, and you know, and then you got the people who don't understand toy collecting who think we're ruining it when we're not. It's just things are changing, you know. Like I said, kids want to play video games. Especially with some of the recent stuff in the news that I'll mention in here. I got a list of stuff I want to talk about. And reasons why I think Toys R Us is on the decline. And I don't know when it'll be when Toys R Us will go out of business. Because they will go out of business someday. Well, I mean, I hope they don't. But the white people are already protesting that they don't want to shop there anymore. Especially with Toys R Us decision to open on a day they should be opening on. Yeah. I mean, the end has come for Toys R Us, sadly, and I don't want to see that, but, you know, and I've outgrown, you know, I don't know. I mean, in a way, I've kind of outgrown really caring a whole lot, but at the same time, you know, I'm not a child anymore, but I still, you know, I like toys, and it's just because that's something fun to do to all you people out there who don't understand why people like me like to collect toys, but, you know, whatever. So I'm going to read my list. Kind of a, not a top 10, I don't know, because some might be more than one point here, but they all relate to each other. So the first one I'm going to say is customer service or lack of knowledge of toys, and also return policy will link in there somewhere. And just the fact that Toys R Us sucks nowadays. You can't go in there and ask them what they have and then expect them to tell you where it is. They give you the same excuse, oh, this is all we have in stock. Like, they won't even bother to go look at the back. And don't expect, you know, to get help with your online orders. I've seen a lot of people complain on the Facebook page about their orders being late or getting the wrong thing and then being put on hold for, you know, hours and hours before finally saying screw it and hanging up. And, you know, it's like their customer service is getting bad. Even when they try to, you know, bullshit you, say, oh, we want to help you, and all, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, no, I mean, I've never made a return to Toys R Us, but I definitely won't anytime soon, especially since I don't plan on shopping there. And also, their return policy, apparently, they require an ID. Now, I don't know if I'm going to hate on that so much. Some people hate it. Some people don't. I mean, I can see with all the stuff that happens recently with people who buy figures and swap them out and then try to return them. I mean, yeah, that is kind of bad, but I don't know. I mean, that one I'm a little mixed on. A lot of people hate that. I see people complain about the return policy. And then I want to talk about theft. And then, you know, people buying figures and scalping them. And as I just mentioned with the return policy, people returning figures that, you know, they swapped out. And how that's kind of affecting Toys R Us a little bit. I mean, and it affects not just Toys R Us. Walmart and Target and Kmart and everywhere else have that problem too when it comes to, you know, in-store retailers. But definitely Toys R Us. And Toys R Us don't seem to give a crap. If you run out of the store with a toy, they ain't going to stop you. I mean, depending on what you're taking, obviously. But then, I guess a lot of places don't. Then, their distribution kind of sucks, and just keeping stuff in stock. I mean, last time I went to my Toys R Us, because we only have one in the Wichita area, it sucked. Barely anything in stock that I really wanted. I mean, and sometimes they do have stuff in stock, but when it comes to stocking their exclusives, you know, especially the WWE stuff, they took forever to get more of the JR figures in stock, and I haven't been back there since the last time I went back, and just as I said, screwed and bought their figures online. And not through them, by the way. And speaking of the Build-A-Figures, the Paul Bearer set has still not appeared here in the United States. Yeah, it's been in Canada and all over Europe and anywhere else they've put it, you know. But still not here. Heck, they're even starting to stock the Kane Build-A-Figure set, like, over in Canada and maybe parts of Europe, and it's like, what the hell? You're based here in the United States of America. This is nothing against my, you know, anyone international. You guys should get the figures too, but why are everybody else getting the figures first, and yet we here in the United States are still waiting? I don't know if it's just because they want to wait till Christmas time to put the figures, you know, in their stores, or I don't know what the hell's going on, but it's ridiculous, and I don't know. I've been tempted to buy the set off eBay, but I don't know. Maybe one of the reasons is they can't get rid of the dang Teddy Long and Booker T Build-A-Figure sets that nobody wants anymore, but, you know, I don't know. I really don't know. And then, of course, competition's a big reason. Obviously, when you got Walmart and Target and Kmart, even though I think Walmart and Target more, because Kmart's kind of suffering themselves, because Sears isn't doing too well, and that's who owns Kmart, and, yeah. You know, and then just, I don't know, I mean, and it's also a lack of real toy store competition. It's just the main retailers, you know. You used to have KB Toys back in the day and several other places that I've never heard of that are gone. And Toys R Us bought them out or somebody else bought them out. But now having competition from Target and Walmart, which Target seems to be doing better than Walmart, but Walmart still does decent. Still, I mean, I guess it's another factor why Toys R Us probably doesn't have the best stock of stuff. And then you got to factor in, we have a lot more online sellers from eBay to Amazon. Big Bad Toy Store, hell, for wrestling figures, go to Ringside Collectibles, I mean, and the list goes on and on of all the different toy stores you can go to online, so it's kind of like Toys R Us is doing their best to compete with online sellers, but it seems like, yeah, even if you have to pay more online, if you are willing to go that route, then go into Toys R Us or go to ToysRUs.com to get the figures. Then let's get to some of the big stuff that's happened recently, why I really think Toys R Us is on the decline. First, when it comes to us collectors, a lot of us collectors were not happy when Toys R Us decided to listen to some stupid mother when she had a petition to have the Breaking Bad toys removed. Now, she had no problem with the series. But here's the problem. She still didn't want the toys in stock. Well, if you didn't have a problem with the series and you're afraid your kids want the toys, then it probably means you let your kids watch a series you think they're going to know that it has meth in it. Now, keep in mind there's still other, you know, toys that are sold at Toys R Us for adult collectors, like Walking Dead, and there's, various movies like RoboCop, Terminator, Alien, and the list goes on and on of the collector aisle, and people are freaking out, said, oh, there's, this stuff shouldn't be at Toys R Us, why don't you sell sex toys there too while you're at it? Oh, shut the hell up. And yet, we still have violent games there like Grand Theft Auto and Call of Duty, which I'm not going to rant, it's just don't let your kids play those games, just like you don't let your kids have those toys. Don't have a toy store decide what you want them to take off the shelves, because you can't tell your kid no. And if your kid knows what meth is on, you know, a Breaking Bad toy, once again, means you let your kid watch the show, and that's on you, not the toy company, or, you know, anyone else. I mean, it's just like with the FCC, when you complain to the FCC to have a show removed, when you don't have to let your children watch it, like Breaking Bad, which is not even on anymore. I don't understand these people I'm going to call moral crusaders, because they think they know what's right, but they can't tell their kids no, so they expect, like, retailers to do it for them. It's stupid. I don't get it. And speaking of the moral crusaders, I'm going to kind of side with Toys R Us on one point. Apparently people are freaking out that Toys R Us ran a commercial during the CBS series Two Broke Girls, which promotes sex and one-night stands and all other sorts of stuff that you see in sitcoms. Are you people really that fucking stupid? Excuse my language, but to all you people who freaked out because Toys R Us ran an ad during a sitcom that you think is inappropriate for your children, one, your children are not watching it anyway, and you shouldn't let them watch it. And two, you know, as we're getting closer to Christmas, especially Black Friday, which, if Black Friday isn't going to exist anymore, which that'll be my last point, Toys R Us is going to run commercials on all the networks because we're going to start seeing Christmas programs soon. And CBS is going to run shows like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, Frosty the Snowman, and various other Christmas shows in the time slot of, you know, Two Broke Girls on, you know, certain times. Like maybe once a week they'll do a Christmas show in that spot, then they'll go do Two Broke Girls next week, and so on and so on. I mean, and people are going to freak out thinking that Toys R Us is actually promoting a show that they don't probably care about. I mean, it's advertising, people. It has nothing to do with them promoting the show. I mean, if I didn't think people in this country could be any stupider when they complain about stuff like this, I mean, give me a break. Now, the last thing, this is going to really hurt Toys R Us, and people are just already saying they want nothing to do with Toys R Us, and that's, well, opening on Thanksgiving. Now, I'm not going to complain. I just say, you know, I'm not going to shop on Thanksgiving anyway. I don't even do Black Friday. I never have, never will. I don't get the point of Black Friday because it's not people want to buy gifts. They want to see what deals they get for themselves. But, yeah, I mean, I do side with some people saying that, you know, the employees who work there should be working on Thanksgiving. Then you got the people who say, well, you know, then the police shouldn't work on Thanksgiving, or, you know, people in motels or gas station attendants. Big difference. That has a little more to do with stuff that we need. We need gas. We need to make sure our law enforcement and our firefighters and paramedics are working. Yeah, they'll still get time for their family for Thanksgiving, but, you know, those are important. And people staying in hotels for the holidays, but people don't need to go out shopping on a day they're supposed to be with their family. And I don't think stores should be open on Thanksgiving either. And there are a few that aren't, like Costco, and there's a few others. So, I don't know. I mean, like I said, the best you can do is just don't shop there. Just either wait till Black Friday or be civil and, you know, wait till after Black Friday. Because so many people have gotten hurt or killed on Black Friday. And I don't know if they really think this is going to solve things. You know, move it to Black Friday to Thursday on Thanksgiving night. It's corporate greed, and that's a rant for another day. I'm not even going to really talk about that because I don't care a whole lot. I just make my stand by just saying I'm not going to shop there. And it's sad. You know, Toys R Us was the best place when I was a kid. You know, great big old toy halls. If I could find you pictures, I would. It's hard to find them because I'm pretty sure no one was bringing cameras back then to Toys R Us because we didn't even have camera phones back then. I mean, hell, you had to have a lot of money to even have a cell phone back then, and all a cell phone was for calling. That was it. So, times have changed in over 20, 30 years since Toys R Us was actually the greatest toy store ever, where a kid could be a kid, not want to grow up and all that. Anyways, thought I'd make this video. I really wanted to do it, you know. I figured Christmas time coming up and all, and just because I feel like, man, Toys R Us, if Toys R Us is still in business within the next 5 years, I'll be surprised, and I'll applaud them, but I think they really need to fix their image and just focus on just trying to make their toy store the best again, even if they're the only real toy store left in retail. And remember, just because you can cater to children doesn't mean you can't also cater to adults, because, you know, we're the ones kind of also helping you stay in business, Toys R Us. Remember that. I mean, it's great you guys still sell toys to kids. I mean, you should. I still want to see Legos there, you know. Thomas the Train Engine, and all the other various toys you sell for kids, but man, just keep the collectors in mind, too. I mean, hey, you guys see dollar signs, and we give you lots of dollars. Even though I'll personally be going to Walmart for my holiday shopping, just let y'all know, that's my personal preference. Anyways, I want your guys' opinion on this video. Let me know what you think about Toys R Us, and how they've changed in the last few years. Of course, I know there's a lot of you who are kids, you probably never got to see the old Toys R Us, so you don't probably know what I'm talking about unless your parents probably tell you about it. But and then if you're a collector like myself, an older fan that primers the old days, you know, hey, give me your memories of Toys R Us and your opinions on all the stuff that Toys R Us is doing now. And, you know, as always, guys, that's really about it. Of course, if you like this video, hit that like button. And if you ever want to see more videos from me, just hit the subscribe button, you know, because I'll do more than just these videos. I'll probably do more toy pickup videos. I'll try to show my collection one of these days and other things. Anyways, thanks for watching, rock on, and keep collecting.